Hello viewers, in the last video, I explained merits and demerits of using board. In this video, do's and don'ts needs to be followed while using board will be explained. There are certain skills that need to be mastered while using board by teacher. First is the pre-planning. Whenever the teacher is using this teaching aid known as board, pre-planning is must. The board is as effective as the lesson it accompany. So while preparing a lesson plan, the teacher need to decide what type of content need to be presented by using which teaching aid. And always ensure the availability of different material while using board, such as marker, duster. Always keep the board clean. If the board is not clean properly and teacher starts writing on the board, it is possible that the content is not visible to the student who are sitting in the last rows of class. At the end of your lecture too, always make sure to clean the board to avoid inconvenience at the part of other teacher. The board must be placed on a flat surface and that surface need to be well lighted. When the teacher is using board, the organization of board space is must. The board need to be divided into three different columns. Left column of the board where lesson outcome need to be enlisted by the teacher. The central column of the board is known as working area or developmental area. The teacher need to develop the content in the central portion of the board and presented the content to the student with the help of this column. Business area of the board is the right column of your board, and in this area any additional information, say for example if any formula that is used by the teacher again and again, any abbreviation that need to be known by the student to understand the content, those type of information need to be in business area of the board. When it comes to writing on board, always write in simple and crisp form. Word choices must be according to the level of the student because board writing serves the purpose of class notes. Only key points need to be mentioned. There is no requirement to write a full definition on the board because board writing will promote understanding level of the student. While writing on the board, lettering is an important aspect to consider. The board writing must be large enough to be seen by the most distant student of your class, and the teacher can also use different color of markers as well as chalk if he or she is writing on a blackboard to make the presentation effective. Usually the size of the font for capital letter is 40 mm, and for smaller letter it is taken as 27.5 mm. But to calculate the size of the font, the teacher needs to count the number of spaces from the rearmost seat. The size of the capital letter in height should be 4 times the distance of number of spaces and 2.5 times the distance of rearmost seat for smaller letter. Spacing between the two lines must be 2/3 of the height of capital letter. When writing on a board, speed is an essential component to consider. It also helps in oral exposition, but not at the price of legibility. Walk as you write and walk slowly because the students are there to understand what you are trying to convey with the help of your board writing. If there is a requirement to display a complicated figure to the class along with the explanation that need to be developed in front of the student, the teacher can take help of another teaching aid. Maybe, for example, PowerPoint presentation can be used by the teacher to display a diagram and explanation can be developed on the board. When it comes to very simple diagrams that are essential to explain principle, the teacher need to draw that simple diagram on the board and label that diagram neatly and carefully so that the student can understand the principle effectively with the help of that diagram. These are certain do's that need to be followed. Now the discussion will be on what are the various don'ts that need to be followed while using the board. If the teacher is using abbreviation that is not known to the students, in that case the abbreviation need to be mentioned by the teacher in business area of the board. Never use the corner of the board because it affects the visibility of the students, especially who are sitting in the corner of the class. Whenever the teacher is using board, do not turn your back to the student. Once your writing is over, stand on one side and try to explain the content to the class. Never underline or double line the headings on board. And the last don'ts that need to be followed by the teacher is, do not erase part of a problem and assume that students can recreate the whole problem instantaneously. At the same time, do not completely cover your board in the initiation phase of your lecture. Try to develop the content according to the demand of the student, and explanation need to be given according to the nature of the content. So these are the certain do's and don'ts that need to be followed by the teacher while using the board, and these are the references that I have used for preparing this PowerPoint presentation. I hope you are benefited with the explanation on do's and don'ts that need to be followed while using board, and next time when you are going to deliver your instruction with the help of this teaching aid, you can incorporate changes accordingly. Thank you very much.